The boys in the hood are always hard. You come talking that trash, we'll pull your car. Knowing nothing in life but to be legit. Don't quote me, boy, cause I ain't said shit.
The movie Boyz N the Hood takes place in South Central LA. It follows three friends' lives, Trey, Ricky, and Doughboy. They all take different paths. Trey, who is an exceptional father, Fury Styles, who teaches him about life, safe sex, and how to get out of South Central. Ricky, who as a child is trying to get a football scholarship to USC. The only way he can get it is if he scores over a 700 on his SATs. Doughboy ends up getting involved with gangs, drugs, alcohol, and he and Ricky are brothers. And throughout the movie, you see their mother favoring Ricky. They all end up taking different paths in the end. Trey goes to college and gets out of South Central, while Ricky ends up getting killed in a drive-by by a rival group. Ricky's mother blames Doughboy for this death. Doughboy avenges his brother's death and kills all the members of the other group and is killed soon after in street violence.
In Boyz N the Hood, we believe that there were two main themes to the movie, the first of which was being successful in getting out of South Central Los Angeles. Jason Furious Styles was a huge contributor to the message of being successful in the movie. He was the father figure that Trey had to teach him wrong from right and responsibility that Ricky, Doughboy, and Chris did not have. In the end, this is proven true when Ricky and Doughboy end up dying and Trey ends up going to college. Because there aren't more fathers like Jason, the violence, lack of education, and responsibility will never go away. Ricky Baker showed another aspect of making it out of South Central Los Angeles. He was a student athlete who always earned high marks in school. Growing up, he was in love with the game of football and ended up being eligible for a scholarship to the University of Southern California. His career and life were brought to an abrupt end at the end of the movie when he was gunned down by other gang members due to a previous altercation. Gang and affiliation violence also plays a major role in this movie. Different groups of people need to have a sense of ownership over the area they come from and want to keep those they don't like out of it, by any means. Because of this, everyone, especially Doughboy, is always looking over their shoulder to see who is driving down the street or who is walking behind them. It is because of an altercation between Doughboy and another group of people that resulted in the death of Ricky and their retaliation to kill all those who took part in Ricky's murder.
John Singleton was born January 6, 1968 in Los Angeles, California. Singleton graduated from high school in 1986 and became a film student at USC, winning three awards from the university. During this time at USC, Singleton wrote the script for Boyz N the Hood. After the film was released, Singleton was nominated for an Academy Award. This made him the youngest at age 24 to be nominated, and he was also the first African American. Singleton notes that much of his movie's ideas came from his own experience in South Central LA. You can tell from his childhood that he represents Trey Styles because he was raised in a separate household since his parents were unmarried. His parents, like Trey's, also made sure he was focused on his studies instead of street and gang life. For us, Boyz N the Hood was a movie that showed the true hardship African Americans face in poverty-stricken and crime-ridden neighborhoods. It also represented the struggle for which these people face trying to escape the drugs and violence that made up their hood. Many of the articles' reviews agreed with our opinion on the film.
According to Janet Maslin of the New York Times, Mr. Singleton's film proceeds almost casually until it reaches a gut-wrenching finale, one that is all the more disturbing for the ease with which it envelops the film's principles. To see these black films come to the forefront was something that was pretty significant. Instead of being represented, you have a case of people trying to represent themselves, said Christine Ackham. Ackham believes that Singleton focused on African-American culture and made sure that their lifestyle and experiences were portrayed in the film accurately.
This is a movie that doesn't just show good guys and bad guys and easy confrontation and violence and who gets shot is the one who loses and who holds the gun is the one who wins. It shows traps that people can fall in and ways that they can avoid falling into them, and it's a really great movie.
The 1980s saw a huge increase in the number of gangs. All the ideas of the Black Panther Party and the Brown Berets were completely lost by this time. The gangs were exclusively focused on territory and crime. In many areas, each block had a different gang, and some blacks had more than one gang on them. As the influence of gangs spiraled out of control with the introduction of drugs to the community, the early 1990s saw some of the highest homicide rates ever. However, there was a major drop in homicides after the LA riots. Much of this has to do with the gang truce that was established among the projects in Watts. Today, gang-related homicides are at an all-time low. Many gang members have found themselves in jail due to a huge police focus on reducing the crime rate. At the same time, there has not been a large decrease in the number of gangs. Today, the police nature of gangs has been completely lost. For many people, gangs fill some sense of family or belonging that has been missing in their life. Some of the main points scholars have touched down on when discussing Boyz N the Hood is the real aspects of the movie, how women are portrayed, and how it isn't following the status quo of Hollywood. Michael Dyson believes black culture is expressed in this movie, saying, "Boyz not only demonstrates advances in black film history, but imaginatively fleshes out abstract data and sociological investigations of black life." When talking about women being portrayed in the film, Robin Wagman says, "My own political desire," she writes, "is not to appropriate black male cinema for feminism, but to place the dilemma of feminism squarely within the discursive field of black masculinity." She believes that women are portrayed negatively in the film because of the horrible mothering shown throughout. The last topic that scholars have looked into is the uniqueness of how the movie doesn't conform to the white status quo past movies dealing with African Americans have. Jackie Jones explains this, saying, "This new homeboy cinema does not threaten existing conventions. Instead, it exists as a modification of sensationalist Hollywood formula."
When the movie was released, gang violence erupted in a movie theater from opposing gangs going to the same show. According to Richard W. Stevenson, gunfire and pandemonium broke out in the movie theater on the nation Friday night, the opening of urban drama with an anti-gang message. Much of the gang violence appeared to have been started by rival gangs, and much of it took place in Los Angeles, where the film Boyz N the Hood is set. In all, there's incidents at 20 of the 900 theaters showing the film, according to the distributor, Columbia Pictures. However, on other terms, according to Tim Swanson, the film had just played May's prestigious Cannes Film Festival, where it received a 20-minute standing ovation.
I thought the theme for this movie, which is gang violence portrayed throughout the film, really opened my eyes to the living conditions in which people faced in poverty-stricken neighborhoods. To wake up every day not knowing if you'll be shot up or not is a startling thing to think, yet this thought goes through these people's minds all the time. Overall, this movie was truly showed me the struggles these people faced and how your future is mostly determined by how you're raised.
I thought the theme for this movie showed the struggle of inner city teenagers going through the things we all go through and a lot more. The movie also showed that how you're raised was a huge influence on how you will be. The struggles that this movie shown were shocking but real. Even though I did not like the movie a lot, I thought it was an exceptional film with a great message.
John Singleton does a great job of portraying the two major themes in Boyz N the Hood. He begins the movie with a quote that states, "One in every 21 black American males will be murdered in their lifetime. Most will die at the hands of another black male." This quote sets the tone for the rest of the movie. The violence in South Central LA is captured through scenes of drug trafficking, gunfights, and gang affiliation. The collaboration of these scenes show the violence that still surrounds kids in these neighborhoods to this day. Overall, I thought this movie was a great movie and served a great purpose. I really think that by watching this film, the lives and futures of many kids in similar positions as Trey could be positively influenced forever.
TV this morning. Had to shit on about living in a violent world. Showed all these foreign places. foreigners living on. Started thinking, man. Either they don't know, don't show, or don't care about what's going on in the hood.
How to survive in South Central, a place where busting the gap is fundamental. No, you can't find a shit in a handbook. Take a close look at a rap crook. Rule number one, get yourself a gun, a nine in your ass will be fine. Keep it in your glove compartment.